Now, I can't really speak for Divesta Zealot or a couple of others and shit, including the female failure, Cynthia G. I can't really speak for them, but like a lot of these, like SysLogic and a couple of others, mostly non-foundational black women, all right? A lot of this nonsense on both sides of the gender war can be laid at the feet of a number of non-foundational black content creators who have, I wouldn't say so much as infiltrated, but the state of black people in the country here, a lot of us are still asleep, right? You think you're woke, but you ain't fucking woke. You're fucking asleep, okay? Because, I went looking around and shit at some of these goddamn videos, testing the limits of my, how much I could take, right? Testing my mental endurance and shit. And I found that a lot of these guys spouting this nonsense are non-foundational and shit. And they're a good portion of our double agents and coons, agents of chaos, okay? Like a couple of months ago, I had a guy write me some nonsense about the Crimson Cure or whatnot. I made it very clear that I wasn't gonna say anything or whatnot. I just really didn't respond to shit. This guy made like a video talking about how she was down with child sexual trafficking and shit. So like I was irritated because it was a non-foundational black sticking his nose in our business and whatnot. And she belongs to the community and shit. So I was not going to say anything about that. That's up to her to deal with that shit. She didn't say anything about it because it wasn't important and shit. She had way more subscriptions than this guy and shit, but I never responded and shit. And this guy responded to me with a bunch of nonsense that was not related to the shit that I talked about. I actually made a video to address him. And this guy did not, talk to me about that, He made some other shit, and he said that he was non-foundational. I just didn't have I had nothing to say to him, right? I had nothing to say to this guy and shit. The last time I was talking to a guy that probably was non-foundational, just talking to him, he changed his whole channel and shit because I told him to stop simping and shit. And I told him to adhere to the 48 laws of power and shit as a starter, as a foundation, because this guy made a video simping for a female, a person of non-ethnic group. That's not why I made the video. I just didn't want to see somebody who said they were SYSBM simping for a woman and shit, making a crying nigga video. All right, he made like two crying nigga videos, and I made this guy I made him an opening. I made him a video, so he could put in front of his videos. I made him a red pill opening and whatnot. How did I get rewarded for that shit? How did I get rewarded for that shit? This motherfucker, the minute that I said something to him, I confronted him about acting like a simp. He changed the format of his channel, and then I think he just dropped off the face of the earth. I haven't seen him. Maybe he blocked me and shit. But, like, after that shit, I was like, I'm not doing shit for nobody and shit. Like, I've made a couple of videos for people and shit, and they ain't done shit. They ain't used the fucking graphics, I sent them and shit, I rock with Bunker and shit. I rock with Bunker. He gives me shout outs. I give him shout outs and shit. There's a couple other dudes that are cool and shit, but, like, generally, like, I'm not fucking around with a lot of these guys and shit. I can't say I'm in a manosphere or nothing, okay? I'm pretty much a lone wolf. That's my MO. This is my standard operating procedure, in case you didn't know. Because, there's some people that do shit in the manosphere I don't like. Now, I remember when Dale Curry was going through his shit with his fucking wife and shit. And, when Itmore put out a video telling the guy to shut up and just pay her and shit because she had been there for so long and she deserved half of his shit. I thought that was a betrayal. And I was like, man, I can never say I was in a manosphere listening to that bullshit. Like, how the fuck you... I don't give a fuck how long she was there, what kind of baby she shitted out or whatever. She knew what she was getting herself into, and she was duplicitous. You know, from all accounts, she was duplicitous behind the scenes, getting her big white cock and shit. You know, for like getting with her zaddy and shit, while they're making a family and presenting a false front to the world and shit. You see, in my fucking opinion, the worst thing, the absolute worst thing a woman can do is deface your family. Okay, that's the power of woman shit. That's what they talk about when they say the power of the pussy and shit. That's what they talk about and shit. The female has your kids. She's the first teacher of the kids, even when they're in her womb. Whatever the fuck she's doing affects these kids. Whatever she's eating, whatever she's doing, you got a lot of really bad female subjects. You know, basic females. They're creating these fucked up people that are walking around today. These mongrel Negroes and shit that's doing all this crazy shit that we comment on from time to time. The deaf culture, all this bullshit. These motherfuckers with lax morals. They got no foundation and shit because the women that gave birth to them, they don't have shit. They ain't shit. They're basic females, which means that they are genetically female because of their plumbing. And I gotta say, a lot of the shit is, you know, it's a lot of non-foundational blacks muddying the fucking waters. And all you gotta do is open your motherfucking ears or use your eyes and ears in tandem and look at the person that's putting this shit out. Look at them. Then they're not of the soil, okay? They have no business in our ethnic communities running their fucking mouth and shit. Alright, I don't give a fuck. They don't have no business. I'm not gonna mince words about this. Alright? I'm shadow banned anyway. You know, if I combine all three of my channels and shit, I'm still probably under 1,000 because of the shadow ban and the fucking algorithm and shit. I don't give a damn. I don't need a bunch of people to hear me. I just need the right people to hear what I'm saying. I mean, fuck. Just listen. I made a video where I busted a bitch talking in both of her ghetto street talk and her regular African sounding voice. And I put up a litmus test and shit. And nobody gets it, okay? We're talking about Cynthia G. She's a fucking idiot. You know how you take her down? All you motherfuckers is mad about her. Just keep flagging the shit out of her videos. Just flag them motherfuckers. They did the same thing to us like about 2 years ago. They went on a flagging campaign and took down a bunch of people. Then they had unsolicited female, simp, beta males cataloging us. You know, making a list. Doing COINTELPRO and shit on us. Unsolicited, by the way. Maybe solicited, who the fuck knows? I mean, Bunker, he was the subject of this motherfucker was trying to dox his ass hard as fuck and shit. Until he made a bunch of videos, then just chased the dude away. He's still out there. But, you know, I gotta say, you know, a lot of these motherfuckers, they ain't from here. They ain't of the school. They're not a member of this slave quarters, this ethnic community and shit from slavery on up and shit. You don't have no fucking business in our community commenting on shit. Alright? We gotta fix our own shit. We don't need your help. I don't want your fucking teachers, okay? I don't want to hear any of that shit. We gotta break out of the matrix ourselves. And then we're gonna do that shit from the inside out. Because nobody's coming to the rescue. Alright? You can listen to all the motherfucking videos you want. Okay? You can see all the bitches. This goes to females too. You can sit up and watch all the head-wrapped, you know, swami-looking motherfuckers you want. On the brother's side, you can see all these supposed alpha males. These motherfuckers sitting out with the mirror shades and the baseball cap. The motherfuckers talking about rocking a snot box and shit when they got their booty busted. Just open your fucking eyes. That's all you got to do. Just listen. All right? You know, I didn't comment on the shit. I didn't fucking comment on it. Because it would be an oxymoron. You know? be a fucking oxymoron. A lot of times I look at some of my subscribers, I know they're trolls. I know they're non-foundational or probably white or something, you know, fucking around over here. I get a lot of suggestions and shit. You know, you don't see a lot of comments on my section because some of my videos have it where I get to screen these comments. And when I find these troll comments, I just leave them the way they are. You know, I let the YouTube clean the shit up because they created this mess. If you want to win this supposed gender war, get some ground, all you have to do is hit the report button and shit. When you see shit like abort black male babies, or like when DMX died and that fucking divested zealot put a pull the plug video and shit, just flag that shit. Just flag that shit. If you have the balls, you can make a video. Just bust her shit up. You know? Just bust it up. She's a fucking nurse. She'll be okay. She'll be okay if her channel goes down. Okay? She don't care about you, okay? You look at her screensaver, and that's the best representation of what's going on the other side of this gender war shit, okay? You look at her fucking screensaver, okay? Now, I'm tired. You know, I'm tired of listening to this bullshit. And I'm especially tired of non-foundational motherfuckers coming in here dirty in the waters and shit with this crap. The motherfucker with the really X-rated screensaver, you know, finally stop writing me comments and shit. I'm so glad. Stop writing me comments. You change his goddamn screensavers. You know, YouTube, visually, they don't give a shit. You know, that was his screensaver, degrades black women and shit. The Vesta Zealot screensaver is a hate issue. All right? It's a hate issue. She's a black identity extremist along with Cynthia G and a bunch of others. And you want to talk about, like, you know, when I'm talking about, like, a non-foundational sticking their nose in, you get a motherfucker like Sis Logic, who's in her early 20s talking all this shit, and she was graduating from high school probably around 2017 and shit, and she a bum bitch. She ain't got no means, nothing. And most of the time you see these females with a goddamn business. It's some kind of beauty-based business. It's not nothing helping the community. It's not nothing static and shit. Most of the time you see a brother, they trying to do something while a bitch tearing you down. Do I hate black women? Fuck no, I don't. But I hate some I don't like. I'll fight that misandry, that fucking mindset, that untouchable, that Aryan mindset. I'll fight it until I'm in the ground. Alright? And a lot of that has to do with a shit ton of non-foundational black haters intermingled in this motherfucker, making video on top of video. I don't feel like hearing it. Lately, Bunker been talking about AK Nation and shit. I don't give a fuck about AK Nation and shit. Just flag the shit. Flag the shit, okay? Flag it. Alright? As far as these females, especially 304s, I have a hashtag for you. It's called Burn the Bag. Now, when I put out a video a couple of days ago about fucking dolls and shit, I did that because I am of the mindset that we need to do everything humanly possible to devalue a female peace leaf. That's extreme. I want to be as extreme as motherfucking Cynthia G when she said abort black male babies. Even posting shit like that. Repeated videos over and over again. Fucking super chats. So I posted a doll video. Because what's their power besides their fucking peace leaf? Huh? What's the fucking power besides that shit? Anyway, that's all I really have to say. I'm getting sick. Maybe I got the coof or something. Or maybe that curse, that bitch that put a curse on me in October, is finally coming to collect. Who the fuck knows?